Blackstone Audio presents Acceptance by Jeff VanderMeer. This book is read by Carolyn McCormick, Bronson Pinchot, and Exie Sands.
For Anne. 000X, the Director. 12th Expedition.
Just out of reach, just beyond you. The rush and froth of the surf, the sharp smell of the sea, the crisscrossing shape of the gulls, their stubborn, jarring cries. An ordinary day in Area X, an extraordinary day. The day of your death. And there you are, propped up against a mound of sand, half sheltered by a crumbling wall. The warm sun against your face and the dizzying view above of the lighthouse looming down through its own shadow. The sky has an intensity that admits to nothing beyond its blue prison. There's sticky sand glittering across a gash in your forehead. There's a tangy, glottal something in your mouth dripping out. You feel numb and you feel broken, but there's a strange relief mixed in with the regret. To come such a long way, to come to a halt here, without knowing how it will turn out. And yet, to rest, to come to rest, finally. All of your plans back at the Southern Reach, the agonizing and constant fear of failure or worse, the price of that, all of it leaking out into the sand beside you in gritty red pearls. The landscape surges toward you, curling over from behind to peer at you. It flares in places, or swirls, or reduces itself to a pinprick before coming back into focus. Your hearing isn't what it once was either, has weakened along with your balance. And yet there comes this impossible thing. A magician's trick of a voice rising out of the landscape and the suggestion of eyes upon you. The whisper is familiar. Is your house in order? But you think whoever is asking might be a stranger, and you ignore it. Don't like what might be knocking at the door. The throbbing of your shoulder from the encounter in the tower is much worse. The wound betrayed you, made you leap out into that blazing blue expanse, even though you hadn't wanted to. Some communication, some trigger between the wound and the flame that came dancing across the reeds betrayed your sovereignty. Your house has rarely been in such disarray. And yet you know that no matter what leaves you in a few minutes, something else will remain behind. Disappearing into the sky, the earth, the water is no guarantee of death here. A shadow joins the shadow of the lighthouse. Soon after, there comes the crunch of boots, and disoriented, you shout, "Annihilation! Annihilation!" and flail about until you realize the apparition kneeling before you is the one person impervious to the suggestion. It's just me, the biologist. Just you. Just the biologist. Just your defiant weapon hurled against the walls of Area X. She props you up, presses water to your mouth, clearing some of the blood as you cough. "Where is the surveyor?" you ask. "Back at the base camp," she tells you. "Wouldn't come with you?" Afraid of the biologist, afraid of the burgeoning flame, just like you. A slow burning flame, a will-o'-the-wisp floating across the marsh and the dunes, floating and floating like nothing human, but something free and floating. A hypnotic suggestion meant to calm her, even if it will have no more effect than a comforting nursery rhyme. As the conversation unspools, you keep faltering and losing track of it. You say things you don't mean, trying to stay in character. The person the biologist knows you as, the construct you created for her. Maybe you shouldn't care about roles now, but there's still a role to play. She's blaming you, but you can't blame her. If it was a disaster, you helped create it. You just panicked and you gave up. Not true. You never gave up. But you nod anyway, thinking of so many mistakes. I did. I should have recognized earlier that you changed. True, I should have sent you back to the border.
Not true.
I shouldn't have gone down there with the anthropologist.
Not true. Not really. You had no choice once she slipped away from base camp, intent on proving herself.
You're coughing up more blood, but...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.